Well, today I got my tricycle in. It's my Schwinn Meridian. It's gonna be so cool. I'm gonna put this thing together. That is really cool. So basically that entire basket, you pull out these two pins and you can make it fold into a flat thing, so you can put something heavy on top of it, flat I guess, or fold it down or whatever. I personally would just want a welded one. I'll probably weld it to make it solid, but yeah, it's still pretty cool. It's almost done. So I ran out and I got a air pump and a bike lock. Now of course I did buy three bike locks just like this back in Illinois, and I forgot to have my mom ship them out here. But you know what, it's not like I'm making minimum wage. I can afford this, so why not? So there we have it, the Schwinn Meridian. One downside that I noticed to it is it's only one-wheel drive. It's only powered by that wheel, I think. Or maybe it's, this one. It's only powered by that wheel. It's because if you had it as a solid axle, it would, well, you couldn't turn very easily. But I would think that at least they would put like a very friction-y thing on the other end, so it could slip, but it would also have a little power going to that. Oh well, I'm going to be adding an electric motor, so it will be two-wheel drive in the future. The front motor actually has already arrived. I'm just waiting for the batteries to arrive that my mom sent me. It's the old batteries that were for my old electric bicycle. One odd thing with this bike are the handles. Just so weird, and it kind of fucks with me. It's like, it looks like almost like it's wrong, like it's extruded wrong or whatever. I'm probably going to replace these just because that's weird. I'm very happy that it came with brakes. Up here instead of pedaling backwards. I am a big fan of pedaling backwards, but I was thinking for this, it probably would have been better in, like, in-town traffic and stuff like that to have the handbrakes. The back brakes seem a little bit loose. They don't have as much stopping power as the front brakes, so I'm gonna tinker with it just a little bit, but it looks like it's a disc brake, so that's pretty cool. This thing is actually really cool. I paid $270 for it, and it's pretty much worth the money. But I think I'd be better to give a review after I've ridden it for a while. Let's go take it for a spin. Pedaling backwards is a bit stiff, so I might want to add some grease to that. Who knows? I like this a lot though. The gearing is really nice. I like the gearing. It's really not that hard to ride. And check that out. No kickstand. I'll probably make a parking brake so it doesn't move around. I think a parking brake might be best. Maybe that's it. Okay, there we go. It has it. Yep, that's a good parking brake. Although it would be nice to have the click, 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 like that lever thing. That'd be pretty cool. Or not click, click, but like that. Anyway, this is pretty cool. Oh, I just realized I had that reversed. Let me flip that around. Okay, guys, so now I'm going to go take it for a ride. I'm going to go run down to Pizza Hut. It's only about a mile from here, and let's get going. I don't know how much I'll film, though, because it's not very good. Yep, you can't see hardly anything here. I'm definitely enjoying this. It's very nice to ride. Only issue is pedaling and trying to keep up with traffic, because around here, I have to act more like a car. Back in Illinois, I didn't really have to act like a car. I could just kind of do whatever I wanted, because there weren't many cars on the road. Dealing with traffic is a little bit issue. Well, I got myself some pizza pizza and I see my bike stolen. Hey, look at that. Awesome. For some reason they gave me a giant cookie box instead of a pizza box, or whatever. It barely fit. You know what? I think what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna go and walk my bike over the crosswalk instead of having to go all the way down and around and deal with that, because I just want to get across the highway. So yeah, I'm just going to walk it across the crosswalk. That'll be easier. Well, guys, that could have definitely gone a lot better. I wasn't even thinking, and I left at rush hour. My bike ride was going really fine until I had to get on the highway and go and turn left. That was difficult because, I mean, I think the main issue that comes down to that around here, it's illegal to ride your bicycle on the sidewalk, and I don't exactly have the stamina to ride at the speed of traffic around here. I can't ride my bike at 40 miles an hour without a motor. So I think right now the big thing I have to do is I have to focus on getting my electric motor on the bike and getting the batteries and stuff like that, and then I'll have good acceleration, and then I can own a lane or whatever the terminology would be. You know what I mean? I can act more like a motor vehicle because I would have a motor. It wouldn't just be me pedaling. So I think that I really want to get a motor on my bike on my trike before I ever really start using it, because that didn't go too well. I ended up having just to walk it home on the go across the crosswalk, because man, the fucking interstate around here is so crazy. My hub motor kit has already arrived. It's the same exact kit that I used on my bicycle, coming from the same exact eBay seller. I think X Series. He was actually only, I think he's a bike shop in like San Francisco or somewhere around here, maybe LA. But it came from California, so this time coming here, it only took like 2 days to arrive. And my batteries, my mom shipped them out, so they should come in a couple days, and I can work on that. I'm not going to bother filming it, though, because, I mean, I'm not going to bother filming me in the process of making it, of converting the bike to electric, because I've already gone over that so much and made so many battery things, and I don't really want to have to deal with recording it again. So, I'm just going to show you guys when I have it done. I'm also going to look into getting some hydrogen peroxide so we can start work on the Lisa, because it does boot up. And it does have a nice little surprise on the inside. It does have a second hard drive. So this may actually be the rebranded 1985 model. Or actually, no. Oh, no, actually, the sticker on the back says 1984. So, never mind. Because, see, in 1985, they stopped selling this as the Lisa, and they sold it as the Macintosh XL. And they had, like, an emulator for Macintosh programs. But I forgot, on the back it actually says, like, made in March of 1984 or whatever. Well, we have a big hard drive in here, and usually the space is just empty. Well, this is a nice little surprise. Unfortunately, though, as you guys already saw, it wouldn't boot up, so yeah. Unless, of course, maybe it just requires a mouse and me to click something to get it to boot up right. Who knows? First step is going to be taking it all apart and de-yellowing it, and that's what I'm going to be using the hydrogen peroxide for. I can't remember if I said I was going to get hydrogen peroxide yet or not. Of course, I'm not going to get pure hydrogen peroxide, because pure hydrogen peroxide is quite acidic. But I've heard that you can put hydrogen peroxide compounds on here. Like, for instance, you mix it with some soap to make it more jello-y or whatever, so it sticks to the surface of it, and then you flash it with ultraviolet light for a long time, or not flash it, but you expose it to ultraviolet light, either you set it outside or you have a UV lamp on top of it, and that de-yellows it. Now, I have a theory that maybe it doesn't require the UV light, and maybe you can do it without that, so I'm going to test that out with the keys. I'm going to test them in dark areas, going to test them outside, then maybe even test them with an ultraviolet black light. But I assume I get a wider range of ultraviolet light coming from the sun, so I'm just going to do that, because I think a black light is only like the very edge of the ultraviolet spectrum, so that might work, might not work anyway. But either way, I'm really wanting to whiten this, because this plastic should be almost like a light gray, or like a beige, but not like the nasty yellow that it is. But I don't know, it might just be the lighting though here, I don't know. Still, I'll give it a try, and that'd be pretty cool. I just want to make sure it doesn't hurt any of the emblems on it or anything like that, because there's also some plastic, like, stickers on the bottom and on the back. But I don't think the plastic stickers will have any issues. I did manage to find some software for it. Like, I found the operating system that people had edited and whatever. So it looks like I may be able to boot it up if I just get some discs made for it. And it should be pretty easy. I'm probably going to get another random computer just to work as like a DOS box, so or whatever, so I can have a floppy drive in it and I can load programs onto it, unless I have my mom ship me out a USB floppy drive. I don't know. But anyway, that's pretty much how my Saturday's been. Hope you guys enjoyed this video, and thanks for watching. See ya!